Yes, this is she. Oh, stop. It's true. No, you mustn't. Oh, all right. If I get one more call begging me to show more of moi from last year's series, I'll go crazy. Stop calling me. I want a life. Oh, all right. Let it rip. I'm wondering if you could take part in something with me, to go back to the BBC studios with me and take part in a discussion group. You know, maybe air your little opinions, tell us the problems of being an elderly person.
Oh, fuck it up.
It's sort of like Kilroy.
Kilroy?
Yeah.
Oh, I like him.
Yeah, don't we all?
Where are we going?
Just sit out. Excuse me, hello, I'm doing a show and we need somebody from a minority and you seem to fit the bill.
Minority?
Yeah.
What do you mean minority?
Well, are you gay?
No, but I'm black.
That's what I mean. Come on. Are you a single parent family? Are you a single parent family? Yes, you are. We're cooking. We got one. Do you mind me just asking a question? Sorry, I'd just like to put a proposition to you. Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm talking to you. Hello? Sorry, do you mind me asking you, have you got any kids?
Yes, I've got seven.
And how are we husband-wife?
I've been on my own for 9 years.
You were left? You'll do fine. Come along with me.
I'm sorry, I have to do the toilet.
We got lots of toilets where you're going. Yeah, you'll do. Okay, come with me. Yes, you'll definitely meet Kilroy. He's waiting for you now. Sure, you can have the whole day with him now. Get the pooch in here. Kilroy will even talk to the pooch. He talks to anything. Okay, I think we got everybody. Can you call out your names? Have we got one old person?
Yeah.
One single parent family? One minority member?
No.
One working class person?
Yeah.
And have we got two witches? Okay, I think we got everybody. Maybe we'll need an immigrant. Maybe not. This is where you're going. Move on. I've explained it to you. You're going to have a group discussion in there. Have you seen After Dark? That's what it's like. I've picked you as different types of people, and you're all going to have a riveting conversation. Come on.
Where's Kilroy?
Kilroy's here. He's waiting. Yeah, Kilroy's here. He's waiting for you. He's been here all day, and he's very excited to meet you. Go in. Yo, Kilroy, love the tan. Gotta go change my clothes. These people.
Oh, God, I was trying to relax. I should be meditating now to lower my metabolism before she arrives. I think stillness is the best weapon when it comes to ruby wax.
Right. Oh, excuse me. Hi, welcome to the show. Sorry, Jennifer, I'm never working outside again. Can you hold this? I will not work without my lip liner. I need to know which orifice the sound is coming out of.
Thank you very much for leaving me on my own. Where have you been?
I have explained this
to you. I am supposed to be co-hosting the show.
I have explained this to you, that each week I like to steal ideas from other shows.
Surely not, Ruby.
I'm not ashamed of it. This is my homage to them. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I was inspired by those, you know, those late night discussion shows where they take real people off the streets, they stick them in a circle, and then they talk about real human issues. It's fascinating.
You mean all the shows they've cut because they're so boring, all those shows?
Yes.
Is that what you're doing?
Some people find them interesting. So I have bothered to go into the streets, and I got one minority person, I got one old person, I got a couple of witches, I squished them into a room. The conversation should be riveting. It should be fascinating.
So why are you doing this, please?
Because, Jennifer, human issues matter. People are interested what human beings have to say.
I was wondering why you were doing it, Ruby.
Because we have Zsa Zsa Gabor on the show, and she ate up the budget.
Oh, awesome. At least you're being honest now. Why are they going to talk about something then?
Because I locked them in and they're not getting out until they do. Do you understand that, Jennifer? Just watch this. Just watch this. This television is hooked up to that room. Just a minute. Let me try and get him.
Ruby Wex. Oh, yeah. I've been thinking who it is.
Ruby
and it's that
Wax.
Ruby Wex. She's horrible. She's horrible, Joe. She's a colonial from somewhere. I mean, back in the north. We come down from the north. We're minding our own business, walking the dog, and somebody comes and yanks you out of any. Ruby Wax. What does she know about him? What does she know about the north?
Come on, you make it a little bit more light-hearted than this. I was reading an article this morning that stated that there's 2,400 gallons of methane gas emitted into the air every day in New Zealand.
Thank God it isn't in Bolton.
Hey, where do you think it comes from? It's serious now, 100% serious. Where do you think it comes from? Sheep. I'm serious. I'm telling you, sheep are emitting through flatulence. They're emitting 2,400 gallons of methane gas over New Zealand, destroying the ozone layer.
Attention, attention, that's boring. Could we change the subject now, please? Come on, I want to see some passion in there. I want to see some anger. Get yapping.
It's not working now, but it might build into something. Jennifer, can I show you some pictures of my last birth?
You'll have to.
Oh, you like this? This is me having my cesarean.
Oh, lovely.
That's me with the clamps in.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing, Miss Kelly?
Oh, Jennifer, this is good. This is them sewing me up.
Yeah.
Look at how the stitches are.
I've seen it, yes.
Smiling yes. Position, like that have a nice day thing.
Lovely.
Oh, look. Oh, no, this is good. That's me when my waters are broken. That's Ed on the floor of the Pizza Express mopping up my waters. Look at him. He looks so embarrassed.
Who was the photographer on this one, Ruby?
Well, I had a professional team. Jennifer, can I ask you a question?
Yes, go ahead.
Do you believe in natural labor?
I do.
Do you?
Yes.
Well, I do not.
No,
I do not. See, to me, it is like going to the dentist and asking for a natural root canal. Mm-hmm. Saying, no, hold the Novocaine. I want to get in touch with my gums. Because, you see, they don't tell you anything about the pain. Nobody ever mentions the pain. They don't say anything. Because we're not talking about a tweak here. We're talking about harpoon season. But this time I've gotten smart. I'm carrying around a hammer with me in case I get a contraction and I'm not near a hospital. I can knock myself out.
Well, you'd probably just find a few volunteers on the street who do that.
All right. Well, they don't tell you anything in the manuals. Nothing.
No.
You just get those books with Jane Seymour in the front. In her frilly pinky smocky, skipping through the lilies, throwing her afterbirthy to the windy. So many things in that manual. I'm like, may I ask you something?
Dr. Ruby.
All right, I'll tell you. Where do you think that egg living inside of you is going to the toilet now,
I know naughty.
May I tell you?
Mm-hmm.
It is going in you.
Mm-hmm.
It is going many, many times a day inside of your body, just circling, circling, circling.
Mm-hmm.
And no matter who you be you a nuclear scientist or be you a Nobel Prize winner, you have been reduced to a walking urinal.
Mm-hmm. Who be I and who be you?
May I just finish something?
Yes, go on.
All right. You are down to the level of a port-o-loo in Piccadilly Circus, except nobody is flushing you.
Yeah.
And you just get bigger and bigger,
until
your underpants are stretched so tall you're like a human slingshot. And it's just this massive sack filled with thickening fluids.
If you don't want to hear about the facts of life,
that's your problem.
Yeah.
Why do you get so skinny? Do you diet? Do you stick your finger down your throat? What do you do?
No.
I mean, you're a stiff.
I diet a lot.
Right.
But I can't stand diet. I hate to diet. Cottage cheese, like an albino, threw up onto your dinner plate. And I always have friends that are thin. My very good friend is Cher, you know.
You're friends with Cher?
Yes. Isn't that great?
What's left of her?
Oh, her pictures are 8x1 glossies. She is so thin. Thin. There's no fat anywhere.
But when you have, like, young girlfriends like that, I don't know how, you know, you can't tell anymore. Aren't you scared, like, of looking, you know, are you scared of aging or anything? Are you frightened of aging?
I've aged.
Have you aged? I can't tell.
At 50, a woman's body drops.
Are you over 50?
Oh, please. On my 50th birthday, my boobs were up here. As they brought in the cake, they just hit the cake. I can't tinder's china for my bedroom. It's a nightmare. And I use my left boob as a stop on the tub. It is just not good. Men's bodies drop.
When?
Oh, at 50. And nobody talks about it. Men's balls drop. They can play golf. And no one talks about it, which is not fair, do you think?
How do you look so good?
I do, well...
You do exercise.
Exercise.
Yeah, with what, your cheekbones?
No, and I had a...
come on.
Jane Fonda's my neighbor. I come out there every... You know how guilty you feel? You go out, because her tits
does she look good?
Oh, she looks incredible. But that's all she does. Good morning, good morning. Pick a finger. I mean, it kills me. But she's out there every morning exercise.
But when you look in the mirror, you were fat. You're
very
the type
fat.
That...
Oh,
do you still fat. See a fat person in the mirror?
Oh, yes.
Do you?
Were you fat ever?
I was fat only a few weeks ago, yeah.
No, because there's no hips. I mean, it's all just tummy.
I'm sucking in so hard that the furniture is in my, you know, rectum.
No, I was very fat as a child.
Yeah.
The joke was I was my own buddy at camp. I mean, it was like I had a gym suit that said pass and don't pass on the back of it. Fat, fat, fat.
Living in New York now, is that better for you?
I love New York.
Yeah.
It's a lot like
you
London.
You talk to everybody.
You walk down the street, everyone knows you, and you say hello, which is, you know, and I'll talk to anybody. How you doing? How you doing? I love it. It's a tough city.
But now you're by yourself. You know, you're single
I'm alone.
Again.
Yeah,
you
I'm
scared?
Aware.
Is it scary? Because you were so, you know, you kind of had a, you know, you're, I mean, I understand.
Well,
you,
it's scary
you sort of
because
said, I have a man, I'm okay, and now that you don't.
I'll tell you, at this age, it's very scary because you think if you're ever going to have an affair again, someone's going to look at you. How much soap on a rope can you wear? And, you know, if you ever take a shower with somebody, you're going to have soap on a rope, soap on a rope, soap on a rope, soap on a rope. Yeah. So that's scary. And I know I'm lousy in bed, which my husband never told me, but I say to my husband, what? Oh.
Are
why don't you call out my name when we're making love? And he said, I don't want to wake you up. And that just upset me. I don't think I'm... I never knew I
what
was
what is good in
bed?
Like, let's discuss this
yeah.
here.
So, this what is good in bed?
That's what I want to know. I mean, is it like the pelvic
bed,
action? I want to know. Tell
I
me.
Think good in bed is that the men just stick around.
You mean they're there when you're done eating?
I think, you know,
I mean, you know, dirtiness. I mean, like, you know.
Good in bed just means that no matter what you look like, they say, she's one hot cookie, you know?
Yeah.
And with me, I mean, very often I've made love with a man, they'll put a penny on each eye when they're finished. And then, you know.
It's not flattering.
I have to get my vibrator drunk. I just know I'm not good, you know? And that upsets
me. So how are you going to get the next one?
I don't know.
No.
It worries me.
I think we have to put bait on you.
Because it's not
anchovies.
Men don't like intelligence. Men like them very stupid.
So do you play dumb?
I can't. But all a woman needs, I really believe, is like a pretty face and a trick pelvis. And you can get...
You know, one thing I've just been getting to realize, men over 40 don't like to do it anymore.
Just because their hormones do.
Did you know that? Dip?
I'm telling you something.
Mm-hmm.
They dip, they diminish, they go down.
I thought they, you know, controlled it mentally.
you know? Those fish just
I mean,
go
it was
away.
Love and...
It's got nothing to do with it.
Oh, dear.
Testosterone.
Testosterone.
Remember that word.
Does it ever dip back up again? I mean, at another, like, 65 or... Does it come back?
I don't know. Have you not back? Done it with a 65-year-old? I can't think of it.
What about, you know, the guys that get older that have, like, you know, start having kids again? I mean, they must be doing
well, they have
something.
One last spurt. But anyway, so what kind of men are you into now?
I'm, now
the intellectual ones.
I'm in the middle where I need the intellect
and the
and the flesh.
Good luck. Did you find anything?
Sure.
Could you send them over?
I'll ask him.
Ask him.
Sure.
Is he bright and he's got a body?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No.
But he's still not. He's old in many ways, but very young in other ways, where, you know, he still needs to have more confidence in himself.
Right. And is he younger or older than you?
Much younger.
Right.
And then I have one that's much older.
That's good. So all sides
I'm
get
like,
fed.
Yeah. I think that's the trick, actually.
So
if you can pull it off.
You can get away with it.
And I don't know how I'm going to get away with this, honey. But I'm sure as hell going to try.
You you just keep in touch with Auntie Ruby. I'm going to go back and talk to Chloe.
Okay.
Bye-bye, Grace. Bye-bye.
Taffy Turner, inside America.
Hello, Ruby in London. This is Taffy Turner, inside America. And as they say in America, que sera, sera, whatever will be, stars to see. Was Doris Day a psychic? I think not. I'm here in St. Louis, the gateway to the West and a veritable vortex of psychic activity. You know, there are more psychics per square foot in St. Louis than there are uncircumcised men in all of Israel. Surprising? Not really. You know, someone once said, to know the future is a terrible burden, and if so, let my back break. So join me now on my peek into the future. Oh, and by the way, I predict this will be a fascinating show. Let's go.
I see a man around you. It's not for a while, about 5 or 6 years. Mm-hmm. And I can't get a description. I think that he's... Well, you know what? I think you're the type of person that doesn't care what a person looks like.
He will have dark hair.
Mm-hmm.
I feel there'll be the letter M or Michael or the sounding of that name, okay?
Michael. So Michael, Feichel, Teichel.
He will be on the tall side.
Oh, good, because I'm tall.
He could be short, fat, bald, with no teeth, and you wouldn't care.
His eyes are gray.
Gray.
And his hair is pepper and salt.
An older man, you
That's
think?
That's right. It's like white and gray.
Mm-hmm.
Black.
I see a belly, and I see a bald head, not unlike a Buddha. So get ready.
Two girls. Yep, two girls.
Well, that'll be nice. I'd love to dress up a couple of little girls.
Well, you'll have them.
I see two kids, but one is not yours.
Well, whose is it?
Well, I think it might come in from another marriage or an adoption, or it could even be a dog.
Now, Ethel Reed is a very unusual name. How did you get that name? Where's it from? Is it a family name?
Well.
Oh, Miss Burns.
Well, my parents had met at one time Ethel Merman.
Oh, I see.
And so she became a friend of our family.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was named after her. At times, I can feel her in me. I can feel her, but she's passed on now.
Yes.
And I can feel her in me.
Could you call her?
Well, I really don't like to do that because it's not something that I call her. It's something that she embodies me.
Right.
And
But we'd love to have her here and have her sing.
I'll see what I can do.
Okay, thank you so much. Ethel Merman, please come to us. There's no business like show business. Please come. Ethel Merman, please come. Ethel, please come. There's no business. Mm. I know everything about a business. Mm. Come. Please come.
Ma! Hello, Taffy! You'll be swell! You'll be great! Gonna have the whole world on a plate! Starting here!
Oh. Now, just to get back to a question I asked you earlier, my future husband.
Yeah.
He's a dark-haired man who's tall.
That's right.
Do you have any eye coloring? Can you see any eye color?
Brown.
Brown eyes, dark hair,
yep.
Tall.
About 6 foot.
6 foot tall.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
What's your name?
Michael.
Michael?
Yes.
How tall are you?
I'm about 6 feet.
6 foot?
Yeah.
And your name is Michael?
Yes, it is.
And how old are you?
I'm 24 years old.
You are?
Yes.
A little young, but what the heck?
Okay.
Michael, what if I were to tell you you're my future husband?
I believe you.
You would?
Yes, I would.
Yeah. Oh, can you bear children?
I certainly can.
Oh, no, that's my job.
Win.
Okay. Well, it looks like Morris was right. I found my future husband, and his name is Michael.
Thank you, Morris. It's good to see you.
I'm coming out of the meat closet right now. Thank you.
I like to eat things that cluck, okay? Everybody faint now or can it. But I don't eat happy baby frisky things. I draw the line there. I only eat big old adults with emotional problems. Divorced chickens, those I'll eat.
Personally, I like to go to a farm and play Leonard Cohen records. An animal can still sit up. It's mine.
Chickens who don't want to live anymore, ones thinking about suicide, those I'll eat. You know, the ones tired of the grind, they're tired of churning out eggs twice a day, tired of people laughing at their legs, those I'll eat. I go to a butcher, I don't ask, was it corn-fed? You're royalty if you're corn-fed. That's like eating the Duchess of York. I ask if the chicken looked depressed, is there any mental illness in the family? You know, did the father dress up as Colonel Saunders and scare the pants off of the kids? That kind of thing. Oh, no, look at this chicken. Look at this, it's depressed. It tried to slash its own wings from boyfriend trouble. Huh? Jen, forget the contestants.
Getting them.
I'd like you to meet Fern.
Fern. Hello.
She will be playing our game this evening, and her lovely dog, Ruby.
I've brought Ruby along to meet you, and she's brought you a present.
Ruby's given me the flowers.
Mm-hmm. She's given you
with
the
flowers. With her paws?
With
she
her
picked
paws,
the flowers?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Jennifer, give me the mic. Thank you very much. Is she supposed to look like that, or was there an accident?
No, that's the way she looks.
So, Fern, tell me, what do you do for fun?
Do for fun? I love going to glamorous string fellows, having a good time. And looking after my two dogs, the other one called Fred.
Fred, yeah. That's fascinating. Anyway, have you ever won any other prizes?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I won Miss Lovely Legs.
For what particular aspect? For firmness?
Oh,
or?
Yes, for firmness. We got right up to here.
Isn't that adorable? Yeah. Any other contests?
Yes, Miss Bikini out in Spain.
And how did we win that, or who did we do it to? Or?
Yeah. I had to walk right round the dance floor with a bikini on, very clingy.
That must have been very difficult for
you. No, it was very easy. And then I walked into the middle, and then you had to take the top off, the lights went out, and then the lights went on again. Don't ask me why that happened, but it was great.
That's
and it. I won it.
You're not a gal. Anyway, please bring on her father now. That's just a great story.
I'd like you to meet Fern's father, Mr. Fern.
Mr. Fern, how do you do, Fern?
Hello, Ruby.
Fern. Mr. Fern. How do you do? Now, do you understand the rules of the game?
I think I do now.
And
yes.
Do you?
Yeah.
That's strange. Okay. Let me explain to the audience at home. What we've done is we've dressed Mr. Fern completely from head to toe in Alka-Seltzer. And what we're going to do is we're going to lower him into a vat of perfectly normal water. And Fern, you've got to decide exactly how many minutes it will take your father to dissolve, take him away. So how many minutes do you think it'll take him to dissolve?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay, and Fern, are you aware that the average length that the human being can hold his breath is 1 minute, 10 seconds?
No, I didn't.
You're not aware of it. And are you aware that your father may die? No, you're not aware.
No.
Okay, so are we sticking with 2 minutes?
Definitely 2 minutes.
Okay, 2 minutes. Fern, are you very excited about this tonight?
I'm very excited.
Are you? And what will you do with the grand prize?
I think I'll take the lady to Miami, definitely.
Jennifer, how many seconds have gone by? 30 seconds. Right. And Fern, can I ask you, what type of features do you look for in a man?
First of all, look, second position.
Definitely. Jennifer, how many seconds have gone by? Jennifer, how many seconds?
40 seconds.
40 seconds have gone by. And Fern, could you just tell me, what is it that you do for a living?
Well, I'm a receptionist for a well-known firm of solicitors.
Yes.
And I also do promotion work.
You do promotional
work?
Yes,
on cars, boats, and I do this.
Oh, you point to the cars.
I
did we get a shot of Fern pointing at the cars? Jennifer, how many minutes have gone by now? Jennifer, how many minutes have gone by now?
1 minute now.
1 minute now. Mr. Fern is turning blue. Can we get him out now? Jennifer, how many minutes have gone by? Quarter past two. Get Mr. Fern out. It's an emergency. Can we get Mr. Fern?
I'm afraid EastEnders is ruining me.
Really?
I am no longer pure.
What are you? Just a kind of cesspool?
Well, all I am is the sins of the spirit. I mean that seriously.
Really?
Yes.
Well, how do we undo you?
Oh, well, you can't. I shall have to do it myself, but I don't quite know how. But I am trying hard.
But you
what
said...
What am I doing
you
here?
You're making more onions. It's so tragic, and we're all
going home. I'm getting quite mad. My brain's gone. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Do you ever feel...
You're
Do you ever feel that your brain has spread so far that it won't focus?
Into what? Tell me.
Well, into a kind of nothingness. I mean, it's full of mess and rubbish, your brain. Does anyone else ever feel like that? And everything goes in a kind of weird...
Sure, it'll be all right. We're just gonna put the pie in the oven.
No, you're all right, aren't you? You're not... Because no, this could be a first on television.
I think I've got a turn coming on.
June is having the menopause on my show.
Oh!
I've got the rosettes on it, Ruby.
Yes.
Oh,
like,
well,
this looks so fabulous.
Look, somebody
already
has made an awful.
Like, it's so attractive already, you know.
Excuse
it
me.
It looked really nice on the floor.
It tastes awful. Fabulous. I should have had white of egg
look
on
at this.
Never mind. It's the caster sugar. You like this, do you?
Do you eat this or sit on it as a whoopee cushion?
Yes. So, June, yes. How long does this go in?
Oh, well, I don't know. I mean, is it gas or is it electric?
It's a prop oven. Will you just tell me how it works?
I've got caught on the earring. 25.
Jane,
anybody knows how long
pages take. And here's the end result of what Junie
brought me. I've got caught up. I'm not interested in this program. I've got caught up.
What?
Where?
No.
I didn't cook that.
No, I know.
Ruby.
It's a lasagna. Jennifer.
Jennifer, thank you. Take the banana pie home with me. My children love it. We haven't had a chance to eat anything like that for years. Who's going to rescue me from this earring? Oscar, I don't like it. Oh, it's come loose.
Okay, that's it for the end of the show now. Thanks very much, everybody, for watching. Thank you.
Are you going to thank the people? Your people that you've locked in that room?
Oh, my people. My people, okay. Come on, be lucky for Auntie Ruby. She wants another series.
And it's time this country woke up to the truth. And the Channel Tunnel, I hope somebody blows it up before it's finished. For the simple reason, armies could come through it overnight. They could smash this country, this little island, to smithereens. And I think it's time the British people had the guts to say to these people in backward politicians in Parliament, we have no friends in Europe, not one, only Portugal. And Germany means no good to us, neither does the rotten French. We never had salmonella, we never had beef problems until we went in the common market. They're coming from all over, they can even come from Egypt and take over Arabs. This realm, set in the silver sea, shall never be under the front foot of a conqueror.
She was good, wasn't she?
Elderly woman, have you got an agent?
You're fine, she's one of Esther Ranson's, actually, Ruby.
Elderly woman, are you available next week? Could you come back and be my co-host?
Okay, Jennifer, you're out. She's
Thank
in.
God.
Ruby.